Hey guys, what's up? This is Simon. Welcome to another tutorial. Today I'm going to show you why you're wrong about the way you're using your zoom lens and how you can use it in a better way to improve your photography. First of all, I want to address the biggest misconception when it comes to zoom lenses. Most people think that a zoom lens is used to get closer or further away from a subject. However, I completely disagree with that. Yes, sometimes if you want to take a picture of a lion on a safari in Africa, you would like to use a zoom lens to get closer to your object. But normally, what you use to get closer or further away from your object is your legs. First of all, what is a zoom lens? A zoom lens is a lens that gives you different focal lengths, from like 24 millimeter to 50 to maybe 70, 80, 100. Here's what's so important with zoom lenses. So a zoom lens is not supposed to be used to get closer or further away from the subject. And the reason for that is that each different focal length is a different creative expression. For example, a wide angle lens will make everything look bigger and more spaced out. The distance from the subject to the background will be bigger. If you use it in a room, it will make the room look bigger. Or it's used in extreme sport where you shoot something from below and it looks like someone is jumping way higher than they are. That's the right way to use a wide angle lens, not to get further away from your subject. On the other side of the spectrum, you have a telephoto lens, which is like 70 millimeters and up, which basically will bring the background up closer and will push the background and the subject closer together. And I think this is easier to understand if I give you a perfect example of this. I'm going to take the exact same photo with three different focal lengths and just show you how different they look. Each have the same frame, so basically I shoot from the top of the head until the shoulders. So the first one here is shot at 24 millimeter, which is a wide angle. What you see here is that the background is far away. She looks quite distorted and it's just not a very flattering look. The next one is shot at 50 millimeter, and as you see, there's no distortion here. The background has a nice blur. It's more of a flattering look than the wide angle. This next portrait is shot at 105 millimeter, and what you can see then is that the face has been slimmed even more, the background has been brought up further, the background is more blurry, and for me, it's a perfect look for a portrait. And when you look at these three examples next to each other, you just see that these focal lengths give completely different expressions, and that's why you need to learn to use them properly. And if you're not an expert photographer, I would recommend 100% that you throw away your zoom lens and you get a prime lens and you learn to use it properly. For my first years of photography, I only used my 50 millimeter lens, and what it taught me was to actually use my legs, walk closer or further away from the subject, and learning to compose my photos properly. Once you know how to do that and know the creative expression of each focal length, then you're ready for a zoom lens. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any comments, put it below. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. I'll be uploading new tutorials every week, and I hope you enjoyed it.